As Americans continue to face new and difficult challenges, Hiring America is speaking with experts and inspirational figures around the country to help support our veterans and their families during this trying time. This week, we're speaking with Mike Krzyzewski, winner of 5 NCAA national championships as head coach of the men's basketball team at Duke University, 3 Olympic gold medals as head coach of the USA men's national basketball team, graduate of West Point Academy, and veteran of the United States Army. Coach K, what a pleasure. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, it's an honor, really, to be on. And just all of our servicemen and women and their families, thank you. Holy mackerel, thank you. You're the best team in the world, especially in this environment. You know, just know that your service is not only appreciated, but the fact that people look up to you with the utmost respect. So thank you so very, very much.
Coach, we know it's important for you to stay in touch with members of the veteran and military community. What opportunities have you had to do that over the years?
I was in the military. I graduated from West Point a long time ago, and I was a captain in the field artillery. And I try to make sure that I stay in touch, whether I was the USA basketball coach, and we had the military involved. And every year I go up to West Point to speak to the Corps cadets. And I've actually done a few Zoom meetings with our military during this pandemic and with the cadets at West Point. It's not me doing something for them. Whenever I do anything like that, I come away energized. And I think the military is so humble that you don't realize our servicemen and women, just what great people you are and how you're admired.
West Point has named an award after you that it bestows annually called the Mike Krzyzewski Award for Excellence in Teaching Character Through Sport. What has that meant to you, and how instrumental was your time at West Point and your military service in helping to build the character that this award recognizes you for?
Well, everything that I've been able to be a part of and accomplish as a coach, the foundation has been my time in the military. I thank God that I had the opportunity of really spending 10 of my formative years in the military. It's helped me immensely. The military recognizes that everyone involved has a purpose in producing success. And I've tried to use that in building my teams over the last 45 years and the 11 years I was the U.S. national coach.
Coach K, what made you decide to attend West Point?
Oh, wow. That's a crazy story. I was a pretty good basketball player in the inner city of Chicago and all-state player, and I got scholarship offers. And my family never went to college. My mom was a cleaning lady in downtown Chicago and never went to high school. My dad was an elevator operator and 2 years of high school. And so when West Point started recruiting me, they could not believe it. I actually turned it down, and then they changed my mind. You know, they would talk in the kitchen in Polish, and I didn't understand it, but I would understand stupid and Mike. I call it the best decision I never made. And it was a decision based on the trust of having a love and respect for your parents, who were your superiors. They were the leaders of my family. And I think you have to always remember that you have people around you. And during this time, you know, where maybe the pressures can get to us, whether in the military or not, understand that it's not weak to ask for help. It's not weak to express concerns. Don't hold it all inside. Share. We're concerned about the physical health of all of you, but we're also concerned about the mental health. And you have strong people around you. Do not fight alone. Do not let a problem be only your problem, because there's someone who's right by your side, who's your teammate, who might have the solution to your problem. So, be strong about asking for help, not just being strong.
You've taken teams such as the USA men's national basketball team to visit West Point before. What is it that you want them to take away from that experience?
Well, I was dipping them in the pool of selfless service. I told them to do a cannonball, not just to put their little toes in there. We felt that in order to build our USA culture, that we needed to understand what it was to represent our country. not just to play on a team for a country. And our military is our military. They believe it, they live it every second of every day. And so we tried to put them in certain situations where they could not only hear and see, but you own it if you feel it. And when you go up to West Point or you have wounded warriors come and speak to you, when you visit Arlington Cemetery, when you're in all these different places, really it's jumping into the deep pool of selfless service. And our guys loved it. Every one of our U.S. players benefited greatly from their association with the men and women who so proudly serve our country.
Hiring America's mission is to help military veterans transition into the civilian workforce. What's your advice for those veterans struggling to find work right now? And what message do you have for those about to transition about the value that they bring to employers?
I recruit the best players in the country, and they make me look good. In hiring a veteran, you're hiring a top recruit. You're hiring someone who has learned how to work, has learned how to be disciplined, has learned teamwork, has learned values, has learned to do it the right way and to be mission-oriented. I think it's a no-brainer to hire a veteran. I would hope our veterans, our men and women who leave the military and go into the workforce, do not be too humble and say, like, you know, there's no use for me. You know, what can I do? What can you do? You know, come on. You had so much depth to whatever organization you're in. And by the way, if you didn't know that job skill that well, could you learn this in a short period of time? Yes, yes. The answer is yes with exclamation points. This isn't about you never being in the game. You've been in the ultimate game. You're in service for our country.
Coach K, you have so much to be proud of, but how does it feel to know that you're a United States Army veteran?
Well, I'm proud of that. You know, I will tell you, I'm in awe of especially the people who have been in combat. I was an Army officer, but I was never in combat. I was trained for that in a combat arms, the field artillery. And so when I meet people, they don't have to have been in combat, but if they've been in any form of combat, I say, I wonder if I would have been able to do that. But in meeting you, I know you have done that. You have done that. You have been in harm's way. You have put your health and safety on the line to protect my health and safety. Admiration off the charts. Admiration is probably not the right word for it. You know, like in awe of that level of commitment from these servicemen and women.
You're known for your ability to inspire and motivate. Where does that come from?
Well, you know, thank you for saying that. But, you know, Warren, it's easy when you believe in what you're saying. And at West Point, we had an honor code. You don't lie, cheat, or steal. And what you say is the truth. It's easy for me to be excited about something that I believe in. I believe in our servicemen and women. I believe in the fact that they will make any organization better. I believe in them. I only do these things because I believe in them, and I believe in hiring America, and I believe in hiring our veterans and having them serve in the civilian sector.
Coach K, thanks so much for your time today and your service to our country.
I've always been a huge supporter of whatever we can do for veterans in their transition, not just job-wise, but the medical, the physical, the emotional, anything that we can do, we owe it to our veterans to provide that help. Godspeed to all our servicemen and women, and an honor to be on.